Hey, it's SGU, and welcome back to our Diamond Dynasty series here in MLB The Show 17 on the PS4. Today, jumping into something that's a little late for this event, but I wanted to check out events in Diamond Dynasty, and the one we got going right now is Advantage Hitters. Basically, you have to have a lineup full of right-handed hitters and left-handed pitchers. That's all your lineup can be made of for this particular event. So this event was open from the 17th to the 24th. We're past the 24th, obviously, and I was playing this on the 23rd. So there's no way I was going to get to those rewards that you saw for winning 20, 30, 50 games, whatever it was. But I wanted to check out the event nonetheless. So I'm going to jump in here. Here's the starting lineup I came up with all right-handed hitters that I own and left-handed pitchers. So I'll be going up against the Nebraska Farmers in this game. Fielded by the G-Money, 153-433. I think I got the numbers right there. So G-Money and his Nebraska Farmers coming into Wrigley Field here. Actually, he's the home team. Now, I don't really know if those records there that are shown, me being 1-1, he says 0-0. I don't know if those update slowly can be behind a little bit, because the entire night I was playing these games, I showed up as 1-1. So I don't know. Maybe the next time I go back in, that will be updated. Maybe some of you can tell me that you play Diamond Dynasty regularly and whether those are kind of delayed to update. But anyway, trying to break through against G-Money here, or the G-Money, and his Nebraska Farmers. And so far, just a bunch of flyouts and nothing doing on either side. Now we go to the bottom of the second inning here. And the pitch, and well, we've got something on the scoreboard now. Solo home run to left into the bleachers there at Wrigley Field, and the Nebraska Farmers up 1-0. Let's try to get it back here. Well, not with feeble ground balls like that. That's your ball game. I get shut out and no hit. These are just three inning games, but still, the Farmers win 1-0. Now you get two losses in this thing, kind of like you do when you're playing Battle Royale. So you can obviously start again, and it doesn't cost anything to start these event games. But you do have to start over with your winning streaks and all that stuff if you reach two games, or two losses, I should say. So let's see if we can put a win on the board. This ball, deep to center field, back and gone. This time we're hitting the early solo home run, and let's see if we can make that stick for us. This ball hit to right field, should stay in the ballpark. Keeps drifting back near the warning track, but it's caught on the track. Inning is over. Okay, let's see what we can do here in the second inning. Again, a ball to right field. This one much more shallow. Waiting on it, making the catch. All right, we're through two innings with that 1-0 lead. Playing the team fielded by user Choppa Family in this one. And take strike three there. High and tight, but within the strike zone, they call it. Four, strike three. So here we go with a runner on first base, trying to end this thing. Fly ball to right, ball game. So we lost the first game, but we win this one. That same 1-0 score, this time in our favor. So we continue on and see what we can do against Florida Moe's Bros. Oh my goodness, look at this lineup. I got my work cut out for me in this one. Check out the lineup he has got. Now it's not like all-world all-star or anything, but check out that 93 Matt Holliday sitting there right in the middle of his lineup. The cap for this event is a 90 overall, so it's not like you're going against a 99 team. I'm just saying, it's a pretty impressive lineup, and it shows him as 3-1. Again, I don't know when those update, because I'm still at 1-1, and I've played two games since then. So starting off in the first inning, that's Tony Perez going deep. You got a legend taking it out of the ballpark. But Moe's Bros, they're not done there. Some of these pitches I didn't think were that bad. Kind of like low and away on that one, it looked like. He went and got it. And he's going to have himself extra bases with the slide there. Double. Okay. Inning continues. And again, he goes down in the zone. Hits it. Out to left field. Coming up throwing. Will it be in time to get him? Head first slide. Oh, close play. But no, he's safe. And it's 2-0 for Moe's Bros. And now you got Nolan Arenado. At least it's not the Diamond version of Arenado, but still, he goes and gets this pitch and goes the opposite way into the overlook. Would have cleared either way if it was the overlook section or not, but it's 4-0 Moe's Bros as he is taking care of business. Finally, mercifully, the inning will end and we get to go a bat. But in a three-inning game, we're pretty much buried already. Let's see if the pitching is as good as the hitting with this squad. There is a base hit up the middle. Okay, well, got to get runners on if we're going to come back from a 4-0 deficit. Something we haven't done well is put runs on the board so far. Here is Pujols. That's fair down the left field line. Runner is going to go to third, and he's safe. So first and third, and we got something cooking here. Miguel Sano in his home ballpark, going to go opposite field and drive in a run. That's a RBI single, and it's now just 4-1. Okay, come back on. First inning, let's do this. Two on, and that's going to be to short, and oh my goodness, that's a really nice play to get the lead runner. Didn't see that coming. That was really solid. Adam Duvall at the plate, and he hits it. Left field, fair or foul? Is it fair? Three-run jack, just like that, we tied the game. I never in a million years would have thought we would have tied him up in the first inning. Well, now we go to the second inning, and the pounding continues. Deep and over the high wall into the Treasure Island Cove there. Yes, I know Target Field well, and that is not a cheap home run to hit it out over that wall. There I don't switch fielders in time. That icon didn't come up, and I... Whatever. I sometimes get frustrated when I feel like I've got the outfielder that's farther away from the ball, but we'll deal with it. This ball hit to right, stay in the ballpark. Looks like it will, but it is a sacrifice fly situation. Coming up throwing. This is going to be well up the first baseline, and he gets the run. Yeah, when it's all said and done, that inning, he gets four more, so it's 8-4, but we're going to see what we can do here. Dive, and he can't make the catch. It's to the fence. Running and sending him home. No, going to keep him right there. We know we need a big inning again, and we don't need to get thrown out of the plate. So let's just try to get that run home another way, and we'll get it via ground out. Make it 8-5 now, get one of those back. And hopefully we can drive in another run that's standing at second base. Oh, strike three. Going to have to throw down to first base because it was in the dirt, but that is the inning. So that time we only answer with one. What a crazy game through two innings. 8-5. Okay, well, can I keep him off the scoreboard for a half inning? That would be quite a feat. Oh, look at this. Down the left field line and fair. That could be extra bases. Chase that down in the corner by the limestone. And get this in to the cutoff man, but it's a double. And now you got runners at second and third. And oh, look at that. Hit right at the third baseman, and we should have had a double play. Just couldn't tag him in time. Shoot, that's going to cost us because this is to the gap. And is going to drive in two runs. He hangs 10 on me now. And this thing is just getting out of hand. So let's get out of the inning. Can we? Please? Oh, that's going to be a hit also. Drops. Runner is going to stop right there. Oh, rounded first base. Coming to second. Have him hung up maybe. Can we tag him before the run scores? Yes. Okay, well, at least we got out of the inning. But we're going to need to rally for five in the bottom of the third, or this thing is over. Sano is going to rip it to center field, so we're not done yet. Doesn't want to give in that easily, but we're going to need base runners, a lot of them. So with one out here, score 10-5. Uh-oh, ground ball. Should be easy double play. Oh, it wasn't. Did you see him have to leap up there and barehand that? That's a nice turn right there. Anyway, game is over. Player of the game, Tony Perez. He hit the first home run and got things going for Mo's Bros. It's kind of a buzzsaw of a lineup right there. He was definitely mowing through it, and I think he got that Tony Perez from the event, it looked like, or at least he could have, as I think that was one of the event cards. So, nice team you got going there, and I take a pounding 10-5. So that's our second loss. We're kicked out to start over, and like I said, we started this event right at the end of it. So I'll have to jump into an event that we have more time to actually get through, or, you know, make some progress to try to get some cards. I just wanted to get a little taste of it. So when we come back next time in Diamond Dynasty, we're going to check out our first taste of Battle Royale this year. Going to have a little action in that. And we are just going to continue on building Team SGU. I'm having fun. I'm starting to kind of get the bug for Diamond Dynasty more so than the last couple years. Getting into it and getting into the collecting side of things too. So we'll be back with more action in the Battle Royale and Diamond Dynasty. We'll see you then.